Hey everyone, we're starting off today with visiting a desert museum down here. Saying hi to the brown vine snake who has been very curious about my finger here for a minute. He saw it move again. So very curious. I wish the camera, there we go. Focus on him again. He's very intrigued. Probably thinks it's a little lizard. That's something we hope to see. Whoops. Oh, it's not food, sir. Something we hope to see if we go to Arizona in a couple of months. Hello, sir. You're silly. Cute animal. There's been a couple other cool animals, too. Stuff that I would love to see in person while we're out here. There's the lyre snake wandering around back there. He's curling up. There's a little spot there. Oh, there might be two of them actually in here. One there and then this guy who's being all active back there. And then this is probably as close as we're going to get to the ridge noses for a while. So this is probably the Arizona ridge nose, but they look pretty similar to the New Mexico. Cool stuff. So if you want to know what each of these guys are, I strongly encourage you to find some time one day to stop by down at the Chiricahua Desert Museum, situated in Rodeo, New Mexico, down in the valley just next to the Chiricahua Mountains. It's an incredible landscape, a hotbed for herpers, herpetologists, people who want to see reptiles and amphibians out in the wild, because there are so many species out there. And the museum itself is full of incredible animals and a lot of interesting things to look at. And of course, just outside, the wildlife itself.
So hybrids between eastern diamondbacks and timbers are pretty well known, but apparently this is a western timber hybrid. Definitely looks a little different. Doesn't get that same batwing type pattern. He was found in the wild. He's a huge snake too. One of the things I hope to see later today, since we won't be able to see the obscurus in the wild, this is Crotalus pricei. Here's hoping. I've seen Gila monsters several times, but I didn't realize their relatives, the beetle lizards, get so much bigger. He's like 3.5, almost 4 feet long. Being a pain to his cage mate. Alright, as you come in, you're going to be greeted by this personable guy. Coahuilan box turtle, I guess. Not found in the U.S., but very rare species in Mexico. Very, very interested in whatever I'm doing. Probably thinks I've got food. Hello, sir. We've got this lovely garden out here. All sorts of birds active at the moment. Stuff everywhere. Very cool. And we got another Texas horn lizard sitting in the garden here. Look at him. Don't really have to go anywhere to see him, I guess. That's cool. Bobbing his head. There's also whiptails galore out here. Beautiful. And in the pond there is probably a Sonoran mud turtle. Hiding away from the heat of the day here because it's like 98 degrees at the moment. It's very warm. One of several whiptails running around over there. There he goes. We got, I think, a species of thrasher anting on the ground over here. Letting the ants clean off its feathers.
All right. Starting our hike for the day. And you might notice this is an environment a little bit different from what we've seen the past couple days. I am not in New Mexico at the moment, but instead visiting the Chiricahuas in Arizona. The hopes here are finding rock rattlesnakes, twin spots, green rat snakes, and of course the Madrean king snakes. So we'll see what turns out. Not a snake, but that's a pretty darn good sized centipede down here. Pretty sure this is Polymorpha. Same species we got back home. Not quite as big as the Haros that can be out here too. Wet enough that there is quite a good rain out here. Oh, and there's a plateau lizard right here running around. Might just be able to catch him, actually. Yep, got him. Very, very dark guy. Look at that. We got here one of the various Scaloperus species out here. I'll key it up, put the name up on the video for you. This is one of the darkest ones I've seen so far, too. Very muted colors. But still a pretty guy. Some serious claws. These are quite common out here. I've seen several of them already. And they are food for all of the things that I am looking for. Alright, dude, ready? Run! There he goes. And here's a little bit different looking one. More normal colors, and there it goes. So if you were to just go by the current state of the atmosphere out here, you might almost swear that it was a tropical rainforest. Because, yeah, we're in southern Arizona right now, but it is like 80-90% humidity at the moment. Moisture everywhere. Lovely rocks to flip. Let's see if there's anybody home. Not that one. Certainly plenty of habitat out here, though. Guess it's just a waiting game. I have no idea what species it is, or even if it's mature at all, but we got a little mantis running around out here. I'll see if I can get any sort of ID on this guy. Very cool. All right, dude. Off you go. For about 2.5 hours, I meandered up the mountain, finding not much more than other Scaloperus, little spiny lizards running around. Stopped for some lunch, sat down, took in the amazing scenery looking out across the valley that I had climbed up out of before slowly making my way back down. Wasn't actually very many steps back down until I found something rather interesting just sitting on the trail. Alright, it's not what I came down here for, per se, but I have just found the cutest little thing I have ever seen. This is a horned lizard, hand for scale. I'm not sure what species this is.
I'll have to key out. I'm not sure how to tell the babies apart necessarily. Because I don't know if they develop their horns later or not. That thing is ridiculously small. And very pink, also. He is very, very pink. That's amazing. And here's a second one. A little drabber than the other, but it's like these guys just hatched or something. He's eating all the ants that are over here. I nearly walked right by him again, too. It's just out here on the trail. They are so small. Like, literally. There's finger for scale. Look at that guy. So small. Alright, we'll leave you to it. Alright, by comparison, nearby, here's a pair of beetles wandering around that are bigger by like 3-4 times than that horn lizard is. A couple of longhorn beetles trying to get it all in there. Okay.
The next half hour or so didn't really produce much of anything as I wandered back down the trail. I eventually kind of stepped off the trail to follow the actual creek that it runs along to check out some of these beautiful flowers, and as I was bending down to photograph this one particular bunch that had all these butterflies hanging around on it, there was a buzz at the base of the bush.
Now, would you look what we just found? It's just a young one. But it's an absolutely gorgeous one. This is Crotalus lepidus clauberi, the banded rock rattlesnake. These guys are primarily montane species. They like living up in rock outcrops all across southwestern New Mexico and southeast Arizona. Primarily lizard eaters. And they only get to about 2 feet long or so. They don't get much bigger than that. This guy's only, maybe 14 inches. He might actually have a meal in him too. But, God, been hiking up all over the place up here and wondering if I'd come across anything. So glad we finally found one of these guys. They're quite variable in color too. Some of them will get kind of reddish colors. Others kind of get this slaty blue like this guy's got going on. There's some out there that will get this like lime green stripe down their backs. And often they're almost sexually dichromatic in that the males often have that lime color. Females tend to be more reds or slaty grays. So that's at least one of the montane rattlers down. Let's hope we can find the other one out here too. Anyway, can't really do much to mess with this guy, so we'll just kind of leave him right where he is.
My first, but hopefully not by any means my last, because there is so much variability in these guys, I have to find a bunch more to really show that off. Incredible colorations across the range, and each mountain, each different rock slope in a mountain range might have different looking animals. And Arizona is doing something right because it has all three of the montane rock rattlesnake species protected.
He's on the move now, probably heading towards this rock that he might have been hiding under. Let's see what he does. Those are some absolutely gorgeous colors. He's a-looking. We'll just leave him be down here. That is so pretty. Would you check out these dancers? Little harvestmen. They only do that when they see me move, so it's definitely a threat defense, but I'm not sure what it's really supposed to do. I have no idea what they're doing, but we got jets flying a couple hundred feet above my head over the mountains here. This is supposed to be untouched wilderness, not a freaking flyover training zone. What the heck?
Now this guy I wish I'd actually taken some time to do some video on, because this is the other major Scaloperus species that's found up here, the mountain or Yarrow's spiny lizard that's kind of unique to southern Arizona. There's actually several Scaloperus that might be in the mountains, but the Striped Plateau and the Yarrow's spiny are some of the most common up here.
Alright, so not a snake, but at the base of these, I think these are an oak of some kind, yeah, or maybe manzanita. We have the remnants, and a whole bunch of remnants at that, of some sort of, I don't know if these are, actually probably not an orchid, some other kind of, probably Orobanchaceae, parasitic plant. These are the flowering structures here. They've already gone to fruit and died off, so now the seeds are being released. Probably would have to come out here like early April or something to actually see them in flower. They're quite pretty when you do see them in that state though. Very interesting. Well, got ourselves another little lizard. Another one of the plateau lizards up here. Still a kind of pretty little guy. Put him right back on his tree here. See how well they blend in there, huh? There he goes. No. He's under the rock over here. We're gonna pick him up. There he is. There he is. Oh my god. Oh my god, yes. Oh my god, yes. Oh my god. Look at that thing. You are so beautiful. You are so beautiful. Hello. Okay. Let's calm you down and then get some good video here. Well, we may not yet have found a twin spot rattlesnake, but we have found the other, or at least one of the other huge targets for this area, who is very, very curious about the camera. This is Lampropeltis Noblachi, the Madrean or Tarahumara Mountain King Snake. Quite frequently, like this guy, visibly indistinguishable from their northern relatives, the Arizona Mountain King Snake. But they are found further south. In the Peloncillo Mountains of New Mexico, the Chiricahuas, you're gonna keep that? Come here. Several of the other Sky Islands in the south part of Arizona, and then down into northern Mexico. Very similar to milk snakes. But these guys are much thinner overall. And they get a whole lot larger. This is a fairly small mountain king, honestly. He's about maybe a little over 2 feet long. And they can get to over 4 feet. Be amazing to see one at that size, but where are you going? He's coming right up to the camera. Gonna have to readjust here. Come here. There we go. These guys, like other king snakes, will occasionally take other snakes as prey. Up here they might even hunt the tiny rock and twin-spotted rattlesnakes. But they'll also eat rodents, small lizards, potentially birds and bird eggs. So they're quite variable in that. And if we look out in the habitat here, it is a scrubby
side of the mountain forest with a lot of oak, manzanita, pinyon pine, grasses, agaves, rocks everywhere. And he's finally just come out as it's starting to cool down. Like, it's only been about 80 degrees up here and it's been wet. So that may have helped bring them out, but they often come out when it's cool. So early mornings, cloudy days, just after rainstorms, or late at night. Although they are primarily a either diurnal or crepuscular animal. So we've already got a couple of photos, but we're gonna try and get a couple of more. And then we'll let this beauty go on his way. What a gorgeous animal.
This is the kind of moment that every herper dreams about when they head down to the Southwest. Elusive, often coming out only in very cool, odd situations, really fast to run underneath rocks and such and get away. And they love to live in cracks and crevices where you just can't really get to them either. So finding any of the Mountain King species or subspecies is a dream come true. And I am so glad that I had a chance to finally pull that off here. I spent a little time enjoying this guy. He got in a couple nips on me, no surprise, doesn't really hurt. And then we let him on his way.
We have spent several minutes with this gorgeous animal. Look at the belly on that thing too. So incredible. Look at that. But it's about time. We're gonna let him get back to his business here. Look at that. And away he goes.
And slowly, casually, made his way underneath another rock that I would have never been able to get him out of if he had gone there first.
So I'm not particularly good at growing succulents, but I've started to try my hands at a handful of agave. I can only imagine what it'll look like if I can get something like this to grow. It's not the biggest species out there, but this is still almost 10 feet across from spine tip to spine tip. Don't know what species it is, but it's beautiful. So the evening is coming in quickly. I'm taking one last little hike before I get ready to kind of cruise down the mountain as night falls. I had to come down and stop to see this panorama. If you look close, despite there being no permanent water coming out of the bottom of this canyon right now, in this pool, there are little fishies swimming around. There's one. No idea what kind, but there are fish in these mountains. No surprise, this pool is definitely deep and shaded enough to last all year round. That's a little bit new. Whoops, this guy's running away. We have what looks to be I think this is a young Great Plains spadefoot toad. There's another one just up the road, so this guy was heading off this way. See if we can go find the other one real quick. Let's see. Is he still out here? I do not see him. Oh well. We got storms brewing though. That might be good for later tonight. It's a gopher. Hey you. I need my headlamp. Can you let me grab my headlamp real quick? Hmm? There's my headlamp. Now we can see you, okay? Hello. You're so pretty. Look at you. There we go. That is a beautiful Sonoran gopher. All right, we'll get some good video here now. All right, our next snake of the night is your classic Sonoran gopher snake, Pituophis catenifera finus. Very pale and up front, getting darker down back. And they have pretty clear blotches, especially up front, which is one thing that kind of distinguishes them a little bit from their close relative, the bull snake, which they integrate with as you go further east on the other side of New Mexico. This is a moderately sized one, not huge. They can get to almost 7 feet long. Around 4 to 5 is average though, so this is a little under that. They are a very fast moving sometimes and voracious predator of all sorts of rodents and birds, sometimes small reptiles. Contrary to popular claims though, they do not kill rattlesnakes. Rather, sometimes, like there's maybe a couple records where it's happened, but overall, if anything, these guys compete with the same food that rattlesnakes eat, which is the rodents, and they will often den with them as well. So they are really just, they're kind of co-competitors. Anyway, we've already gotten a couple of photos of this guy. So he was going the other direction across the road when I first came up on him, so we will bring him over here. Ooh, wind's picking up. We will let him go right off out there. Beautiful. Oh, awesome. Hello, you. Come here. We're gonna go over here behind the car. Look at that. That is beautiful. Nice. That is a gorgeous long nose. All right, we got another gorgeous snake that has decided to cross the road out here. This is Rhinochilus leucantii. Kind of a familiar face at this point. I've found one on almost every trip I've taken to south, southwest areas. Gorgeous relative of, ow, stupid insects. Gorgeous relative of king snakes and rat snakes, and primarily lizard eaters. So he's gonna be out here going after all sorts of stuff. So there's all sorts of lizards for him to eat. Anyway, we've gotten a couple of photos of him already. So we're just gonna get him moved off the road here since he's in a hurry. So, here he goes. There he goes, beautiful snake. We've got javelina crossing the road. Whole bunch of them. Let's see here. Let's turn that down a little bit. Not the greatest of shots, but hey, javelina. Whole lot of them. Also known as collared peccary. Got a little Mexican spade foot toad here. A little less interesting, actually, than the couches are. Get him off the road. There we go. There's something a little bit different. This is, I believe, a Great Plains spadefoot toad. Either that or a Mexican, I'll double check and put the right name up here. very, very plain looking animals. They don't get much bigger than this. Yeah, it's about his size. Just a little guy. And there he goes, off the road, where he needs to go. A little further, dude. There we go. All right, we have, let's focus camera, thank you. After a little talk with one of the Border Patrol agents, who was kind of messing up. Hold on, he's coming back the other way. Okay, now that the noisy car is passed, we have here Tantella nigriceps, I believe. Plains black-headed snake. There's two or three different species that can possibly be down here. I believe that the other most similar one, though, Hobart Smithi, has a slightly less rounded black cap on the head. I'll double-check just to make sure. But these guys don't really get much bigger than this. They are primarily a fossorial animal. They only are active on the surface, usually at night or right after rains. And they are primarily centipede eaters. So they have a very mild venom. They are a rear fang species that they use to deal with centipedes. And even if they're big enough to bite, that kind of means wouldn't really do much to us. And these are actually quite a common species. However, people might not see them very often because, again, they're usually underground most of the time, hiding away. Anyway, we've already got a couple of photos, and the bugs are getting in the way on the screen. So we will just get him over here. Off the road. And see what else might show up. There you go. You should run away now. Bye-bye.
Well, there's a skunk that just went off the road.
Here. Look at that. It's another tantilla. And I've just gotten the attention of the Border Patrol again. All right, as the insects cover me again, just got to talk with the local Border Patrol guy a little bit because he saw me stop right in front of him here, basically to see this. Talk about a little tiny snake. But we got a second little plains blackhead. He's got this lovely orange belly. I wish I could get a decent light in to show that. Hopefully some of the photos will, but quite adorable. This is a longer one too, a little skinnier. But once again, they still don't really get much bigger than that. That's a pretty lengthy one, in fact. Gorgeous little guy, though. Anyway, so since we've already gotten a couple of photos, we can take him and move him off over here. There you go, sir. And into the grass he disappears. I really wish it hadn't been like this. I need to find a live one. Some piece of crap just freshly hit. This Sonoran lyre snake would have been a lifer. Damn it. Oh, it's a tiny little night snake. We're gonna get him off the road before the next idiot comes and smacks him. Look at that. Yeah. Tiny little hooded night snake. Hypsiglina undescribed species. At least the lyre snake was not the last thing, and I'm still holding out hope. I'm going to be passing through here at least twice. Maybe there'll be another alive crossing the road somewhere, but these guys are not too dissimilar. Rear fang venomous, although different families. Lyres are true colubrids. These guys are dipsadids. And these, they do both hunt lizards, though. And are primarily nocturnal animals. One is a primarily rock-dwelling species, though, and these guys are a lot more often seen in the flatlands, although they will be found up in rocky slopes, too. Anyway, we've already got videos and photo of this guy, so get him out here. Here he goes. Away you go. It's a gopher! Hey, you. Let's go in the car where it's not all messy. Well, perhaps you can hear the thunder back there. The rain does bring out the snakes. Would you look at that? I'm hoping I can hang out here until it passes, but and then see what comes out. I really hope that means the storm will move quickly and not just sit over top of me. We'll see. Second go for the night. And hopefully the storm will move quick. And I can get some other cool stuff out. So at least the lyre snake was not the last snake that we saw tonight, but the gopher snake at the end was. We were not able to redeem ourselves with a live lyre. Small chance that tomorrow maybe I could flip one, but nighttime possibility was going to be the other species in New Mexico, so hopefully I can be redeemed with at least that. We'll see. Storms came in just a little bit later than I had hoped. If they had come in just an hour or two earlier, I might have been able to cruise some more stuff, but overall, can't say I can complain about today. I mean, we got a mountain king snake and a rock rattlesnake, so that's pretty darn good. So tomorrow is one more visit to the Mogollon Rim and the mountains that make that up, and then cruising down into the central Rio Grande Valley. So fingers crossed we'll see some good stuff. But until then, if you'd like to help support educational videos like this and other educational materials that I produce, consider joining at patreon.com/hcarlton. There are exclusive benefits that members get there. You can also do one-time donations at Ko-fi. The link for that will be down in the description below, as well the links for my website at carltoncarnivores.com, where you can find the plants and sometimes baby animals that I have for sale, as well as the database and blog. And of course, if you'd like to see more little video clips, tidbits, photos, and such, find me on social media at Carlton Carnivores, Instagram, TikTok, and Facebook. But until next time, I'm Hawken Carlton, and this is Carlton Carnivores.